For decades, bighorn sheep in Idaho and across the western U.S. and Canada have suffered periodic and deadly outbreaks of pneumonia. Once infected, a bighorn herd can be impacted by the bacteria for decades. It's long been known that contact with otherwise healthy domestic sheep can cause disease in wild bighorns. Traditionally, the only way to prevent disease transmission is to avoid contact between domestic and wild sheep. That is easier said than done. But now, scientific advances in understanding the pathogen behind the disease have created opportunities to partner with sheep growers to explore new ways to protect bighorns and domestic flocks.
We had a full-curled ram come from across the river. He come up through the property just at the end of the field, but the girls were all up here. He went across there and up in the mountains.
Doug Bailey's close encounter with the bighorn ram was a thrill, and not an uncommon sight for ranchers around Challis in the Salmon River Valley.
They're in the middle of multiple populations of bighorn sheep. So bighorn sheep from the Lost River Range, Morgan Creek, the Middle Fork, they all kind of converge in this area during different times of the year.
But when a bighorn sheep comes nose to nose with a domestic sheep or goat, it becomes a deadly encounter because domestics carry a bacteria that causes pneumonia in bighorns.
Bighorn sheep pneumonia is a really devastating epidemic disease. It happens in outbreaks and can kill very large numbers of a population.
An outbreak in the Salmon River bighorn herds in the late 1980s devastated the population and still impacts lamb survival nearly 40 years later.
The best procedure people had for preventing this disease in wild sheep was to enforce separation, to keep the bighorns apart from the domestics. That's been very difficult to do in general.
2 years ago, we had a couple young rams that came down and jumped the fence and got into where our herd was. Then what the fish and game did is they came out there and they killed the two rams.
The only recourse we have is if any of these rams come into contact with domestic sheep, we lethally remove them from the population. We are afraid that they're going to get and take it back to the larger population. So we're sacrificing the few to save the many. It's difficult. We wish we had other options.
New research led by microbiologist Tom Besser has identified the primary pathogen carried by domestics that causes pneumonia in wild sheep.
I'm always what we call a bacteria. Its full name is Mycoplasma ovipneumoniae.
842-0176.
This discovery has led to a new approach to reduce the risk of transmitting the disease in high contact areas like Challis.
Several years ago, we started a program here in the Challis area working with small domestic sheep and goat flock owners to try to rid their flocks of MOV.
Given that some bighorns are going to roam and some domestics are going to stray, the risk of this disease is much reduced if the domestics don't have MOV.
Creating MOV-free domestic herds is a first step. The harder part is keeping them disease-free, even as livestock is bought and sold.
A couple of years ago, we did buy a 4-H ewe that this little girl in town had bought from another area. And unfortunately, it did have the virus. So after we tested it, then we realized that we were putting ourselves at risk with bringing that in.
It's not entirely to do with the bighorn sheep either, because since we identified MOV as the cause of the wild sheep disease, we've been doing more work on what MOV does in domestics as well. And so far, every factor we've looked at has shown that it has a detrimental effect on the domestics.
We worry about their health. We vaccinate them twice a year. We have now included this MOV testing within our health protocol.
This will be a challenge for you.
As the pilot project reveals new challenges, Idaho Fish and Game works to find new solutions. Steve Bachman and his wife LYNDELLA were two of the first to sign up.
We entered into a program with the Fish and Game, and the intent was to provide them a test case of how we could create an MOV negative herd. Twice a year, they would test all of our ewes. If there was a positive, we would pull it off, and if we got a second positive, then we eliminated it from the herd.
We've worked with over 8 producers in this area. All the operations are different. All the owners are different. They have different numbers of animals, so different sizes of flocks. They're in different locations with respect to their risk to bighorn sheep. And it's been good to have that variety to work with when we're trying to develop this type of program, so we can come up with solutions for more people that do different things with their animals.
That's a female.
Yep.
If we can get them all to work together, maybe they can have clean herds. That's one of the things that you work for. And it takes cooperation. If it's you don't have it, then you don't get anything done, you know?
I don't think our domestic sheep, I don't think it's such a critical issue for them, but I think with the wild sheep it is. So I would like to be involved in helping to resolve that, and this seems the way to start.
I believe the future for bighorn sheep is really dependent on being able to work in communities like Challis. We now have a pathogen, you know, Mycoplasma ovipneumoniae, that we can focus on. And by working together, we can reduce these risks of having another pneumonia-related die-off in our bighorn sheep by working with small flock owners. They've been great, and they're pioneers in this work, and they deserve a lot of credit for their efforts.